Which are the first steps to start the operation of a tecSaaS embedded spectrometer system with the MPT software? Welcome to an introduction to the tecSaaS monitoring and parameterization tool MPT. I will show you how to quickly and conveniently use the MPT to start an application on a tecSaaS-based spectroscopy system. The MPT is a software application for a PC which is temporarily connected to the embedded spectrometer system. Even though the MPT looks like a classical PC spectroscopy software, it is only used as a setup and parameter setting utility for the tecSaaS-based spectrometer system, which contains the spectral data processing capabilities internally. For putting the system in operation, the first thing to do is to establish a connection to the system, which can be done by either using the connect button or by opening a so-called workspace in which all device information is stored. In this case, I first connect by clicking on the connect button. You may now enter the IP address of the system directly and the suitable board, or alternatively, use the button Device Discovery to show you a list of available devices. After completion of the scan, available devices in the network are shown. In our case, the demo system with the IP address 180 and the port 9670 is selected upon a double click. At this stage, some identification information is shown, and a click on Continue leads you to the user login window, where you can, for example, log in as a regular user. Of course, the standard password can be changed to a user-defined password. As soon as login is completed, the relevant information is displayed in the top right corner. You can see a typical Windows-style user surface which resembles a spectroscopy application software. Please remember that the signal processing is embedded in the remote system. Thus, the functionality of the MPT software is completely different to spectroscopy software on the PC. At the left, you will find the method configuration showing all data acquisition and processing steps, also called method steps, and allowing their parameterization. In the center, you can see a window to monitor the resulting spectra. At the right edge, there is some status information retrieved from the system, and at the bottom, error messages or warnings may be displayed depending on the software settings. Now, the first method steps show the configuration settings of your system. This is the hardware information which is usually preset on the system and normally does not have to be changed at all. As an example, you could show the sensor type, which is an MMS spectral sensor in this case, with its wavelength coefficients and linearization coefficients, the number of pixels, and some more information. Or, as a second example, you could show the Ethernet configuration by which you are currently accessing the device. In addition, the process interface may be shown with its properties or many other informations about the hardware configuration. As a next method step, you may define your acquisition. With the data acquisition settings for the spectral sensor. This includes a mode of operation, internally or externally triggered modes are available, an integration time, a cycle time which defines the interval between measurements, and a few more. Next, the parameters for dark current correction are selected. How often is dark current acquired? Is it acquired automatically? There are similar settings for the reference, which also allow to acquire reference spectra autonomously by the system. And if applicable, settings for a flashlight source can be changed here. All these settings may be accepted or modified. Of course, for example, I'm changing the value of the integration time. And the new value is then stored to the current method. Then data pre-processing steps may be defined. For example, averaging a number of single measurements, or dark current correction, linearization, or also interpolation parameters specifying the wavelength range and the step width for the spectra to be processed. With TRA, it is possible to define if the processing is primarily a transmission, a reflection, or an absorbance calculation. The calculated results are then available immediately. Also, a reference standard may be selected, and the options for error handling may be defined here. In addition, depending on the license purchased, other data evaluation steps are available for selection. This is, for example, colorimetry, a peak finder, an FFT or chemometric processing. Finally, the results allow you to define various output parameters calculated from the spectral data. Typical examples for this are transmission or reflection values at a specified wavelength. Alternatively, you could also show a system temperature or the current CPU temperature. Once a method is defined, in the left area of the MPT window, this method has to be transferred to the embedded system using the Write Config button. For example, the method is written to the method slot in the system, transferring, and now data acquisition on the system is active with the selected parameters. Now, how can you be sure that parameters and values entered lead to the desired measurement results? This can be done by monitoring, which is activated by the Start Monitor button. So now you can see a spectrum that is currently measured with the system. Please remember again that this MPT software only shows you what is acquired and processed in the embedded system. Everything you see, transmission spectra, raw spectra, reference, and so on, is transferred from the system and shown here in the sense of monitoring. For example, defined results may be shown as well. Of course, windows may be arranged individually. To match the requirements of your application. Once you see that your measurement works nicely, that, for example, the values are changing, are in a good range, you may say that, okay, that's what it should do. Then you can click on the Stop Monitor button and the MPT software on the PC stops monitoring. The remote tecSaaS-based embedded spectrometer system, however, continues measuring and transferring its results directly to the process interface and thus to the central process or machine control. The MPT user may log out, close the application software and remove the PC. The measurement system autonomously continues its operation. This is the end of a short introduction into operation of a tecSaaS-based spectrometer system with the MPT. It only showed a subset of many capabilities of the software. Other features will be covered in more video tutorials to come. Many thanks for your attention.